Gentlemen.
It's a great pleasure to meet this morning with such distinguished law enforcement officials who have been active on the front lines of our fight against crime. I'm particularly pleased to have this opportunity to hear your views on a matter that will have a continuing impact on law enforcement and criminal justice long after my administration leaves office. The nomination of Judge Robert Bork to succeed Lewis Powell as a Justice of the United States Supreme Court. The Supreme Court has always had a critical role in the administration of criminal justice at both the state and federal levels. Criminal cases make up one of the largest categories of the highest court's decisions. I was surprised to learn it's almost one-third of all the cases it considers. And that's why when it comes to crime and the safety of our citizens, it's so important for our courts to take a tough, clear-eyed look at the Constitution's purpose to establish justice and ensure domestic tranquility. Judge Robert Bork, whom I nominated nearly 8 weeks ago, would be just such a justice. His guiding principle is one of judicial restraint. And Judge Bork believes that judges should not make the laws. Their function is to interpret the laws based on the Constitution and precedent. It's time we reassert the fundamental principle that the purpose of criminal justice is to find the truth, not to coddle criminals. The constitutional rights of the accused must be protected, but so must the rights of our law-abiding citizens. During his distinguished career in law and public service, Robert Bork has demonstrated a genuine concern for the right of our citizens to live in safe communities and a clear understanding of the problems facing today's law enforcement professions. As Solicitor General, the nation's chief legal advocate before the Supreme Court, he argued the landmark cases that upheld the constitutionality of capital punishment, a position maintained by Justice Lewis Powell in his years on the court. Last term, the constitutionality of capital punishment in cases of particularly brutal murders was narrowly reaffirmed with the support of Justice Powell, whose seat Judge Bork would fill. It's essential that capital punishment remain on the books if we're to protect innocent lives from the tragedy of vicious criminal acts. As Solicitor General, Bob Bork also advanced common sense readings of the Constitution that would help, not hinder, the search for truth in criminal trials. He argued that the Constitution was intended to assure real justice for all citizens, not to foster never-ending sparring matches between lawyers. As a judge on one of our nation's most important appellate courts, Judge Bork has handed down tough but fair decisions that have protected the rights of victims and society as well as the rights of the accused, and our Constitution, we know, requires no less. Together, we've made great strides in the war on crime. A key reason for that progress has been the appointment of tough-minded judges. For the past 7 years, federal criminal sentences have increased 30% overall. Judge Bork's nomination is a crucial opportunity to continue our progress in the war against crime. The Supreme Court today is closely divided on many important criminal justice issues. The support given to Judge Bork's nomination by law enforcement professionals like you and the men and women you represent can help ensure that Lewis Powell's seat on the Supreme Court is filled by a judge who shares his support for the rule of law.
Mr. President, why are there no women supporters of Bork on Law and Order?
Did you ask Nancy?
Well, you didn't invite any, so your own administration officials take up half the table.
The other half of the table are leaders of virtually all of the law enforcement organizations in the United States.
Democratically elected leaders.
Sir, what can you tell us about the Philippines? Do you think Mrs. Aquino's out of danger now?
I don't know, Sam. I'm not going to get into that. We've got another subject here. And, frankly, we're trying to keep track of what's going on here.
Have you spoken with the Filipino president?
No, I've got to go.
Thanks.
Just shut me off, see?
Oh, no. Just have to.
Would you ask Mrs. Reagan to take our call so we can find out if she supports Judge Bork?
should take the call.
Mr. President, Admiral Poindexter wants to retire in his old rank of vice admiral. Will you support that?
I'm not going to comment on that. I just learned of that myself.
Is that something you'd consider?
Yes. No answers.
Looks like the Russians are planning for a summit in either October or November. Does that please you, sir?
He said no answers. Let's go, please.
Come on, let's go.
You know that I support the idea of a summit. Yes.
It looks good, doesn't it?
Not a comment.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Fitzwater. You're supportive of Judge Bork. Mr. Meese, Mr. Baker, Mr. Culver, thank you, Mr. Fitzwater, for your support of Judge Bork.
I wanted to say, but I think your information, the largest women's group in the United States is concerned women from America by time.
Yes.
Let me just say you get this going on a more personal level. Let me again welcome you and tell you how grateful that I am. You've taken the time from your busy schedules to share your views and those of the organizations that you represent on this important Supreme Court nomination. You know, during the past several years, we've traveled a lot of roads together and fought shoulder to shoulder on an issue which goes to the heart of civilized society and is one of the fundamental purposes of organized society, maintaining safe, secure communities for our fellow citizens to grow and prosper. So today, I'm particularly pleased to be able to hear your thoughts on my nomination of Bob Bork to the Supreme Court, and I think I'm aware of how you feel. His nomination, as I said a few minutes ago, gives us an opportunity to continue into the future the important progress that we've made together on our war on crime. So, Jim, I'm going to turn to you. First, you established an enviable reputation as a tough crime fighter in Chicago, and served as a U.S. attorney there, and I know you continued your dynamic leadership in law enforcement as governor of Illinois.
Thank you, Mr. President. You should first know that all of us consider this to be part of our busy schedule. We're not taking time from it. This is an order of high importance for